Hi, in this video I will show you how to make a text on the solid, and we will do it so that the text will be concave, and we will do it without using the part workbench. We just prepare a sketch for such a text, which we will then use for the pocket operation in the part design workbench. I will create a new project in part design workbench, create a new sketch and select the XY plane as the plane of the sketch, then select the rounded rectangle command to create a rectangle with rounded corners. Now select constraint distance to determine the dimensions of the rectangle, select these two points to determine the dimensions of the length and here enter 60 millimeters. And the command is still active, so now select these two points and here enter 25 millimeters. The sketch is not fully defined. It is still necessary to determine the dimension of the radius. Select constraint radius and select the radius and enter 5 millimeters here. Okay, the sketch is fully constrained. Exit the sketch. Add a 3 millimeters sketch extrude and click OK. Now let's prepare the sketch of the text in the draft workbench. Switch to this workbench and here select the shape from text command. Enter here the text that is to appear on this solid. I will enter FreeCAD. Then specify the font. I will select one of the system fonts. OK. And select more or less the position of the starting point of this text. Of course, later we will be able to adjust this position and click OK. And the text has been created and we need to move this text a little. OK, and let's turn off the visibility of this plane. And now we can use this text in the part design workbench, but to use this text to operate on this solid, we have to do one thing. Let's switch to the part design workbench. And now if I would like to add some operation on the basis of this text, whether it is an extrude operation or a pocket operation, unfortunately, I will not be able to do it. We have information here that we cannot use it because this object must be in the active body. And for this text to be in the active body, just drag this text to the body. And now on the basis of this text, we can add either an extrude or a pocket operation. Just pay attention to what happened here. The whole model disappeared, and it disappeared because the depth of the pocket is greater than the height of the model. If I enter 1 millimeter here, the pocket will simply be made at a depth of 1 millimeter. Click OK. And in this way we added a text on the solid's wall without using the part workbench. In the part workbench additional steps would take place. It would be combining two solids or cutting one solid from the other. And what we did is we just used this text string as something like a sketch to perform the operation we wanted. But this string of characters is not a sketch. Let's undo this operation. And we just have shape string here, so it's just a string of characters. If I click twice with the left mouse button now, I will switch to the addition of this text. It's not a sketch, it's just a string of characters. But if you wanted such a string of characters to be a sketch, we can also do it. I will switch back to the draft workbench. And now to replace this string of characters with a sketch, just click this icon Draft to Sketch. And the sketch has been created. Now select a shape string and press spacebar to turn off the visibility of this string of characters and switch back to the part design workbench. And here as before we can't use it to perform the operation because this sketch is outside the active body. And to use this sketch to perform the operation on this solid, just drag this sketch to the active body. And now based on this sketch we can add a solid operation. But now if you click on this geometry twice with the left mouse button, we will be switched to the sketcher workbench, and in this workbench we can edit this geometry. It is a normal sketch geometry, however here you have to remember that it will not always work so well. Of course, in the draft workbench it will be possible to convert the geometry to a sketch, but this sketch after conversion may not be as readable as this text. Here, as you can see, we still have a lot of different points, and sometimes there may be much more of these points, and any addition of this geometry is very difficult, but it is always worth knowing that there are such possibilities that we can do something like this. Now let's exit the sketch, and based on this sketch let's add a pocket operation, enter 1 mm and OK. And on this simple example you learned more about FreeCAD, and the fact that I show it on a simple example doesn't mean that these functions can only be used on a simple examples, but I leave it to your creativity. And that's all for today, thanks for watching and please subscribe to this channel.